Good afternoon. My name is Dave Bielek. One of my roles here at Chatsworth Pavilion is community outreach. Today, we're going to talk with the director, Richard Hoffman, about abstinence versus recovery. Richard.
Abstinence versus recovery. You know, we want to talk about this because for so many families that send in their loved ones, they think that it's all about helping the person stop.
Right.
Right, they think that the goal, the ultimate goal, is abstinence. Mm-hmm. And that if the person is not drinking anymore, if they're not using drugs anymore, if they're not medicating with the medicator of their choice, that it's done. and I grant you that there's merit to that. There's merit to the alcoholic that no longer drinks. But we have to appreciate what recovery is.
Okay.
Recovery is not just not drinking.
Right.
Because even in Alcoholics Anonymous, you know, they remind you all the time that alcohol was but a symptom. Right.
Okay.
And I say to people all the time, I say, once you stop drinking, once you stop using drugs, once you stop, that is no longer the problem.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So now what needs to be addressed is, how can I live well without it? How can I live well without it? Especially when you appreciate to what extent alcohol, drugs, whatever it be, Sara Lee chocolate cake or work, was actually a medicator.
Okay.
To help reduce stress, right? So what is recovery? Recovery is taking care of your mental, emotional, psychological, and spiritual hygiene.
Okay.
Not most of us have learned how to take care of our physical hygiene. Right. And so, you know, if you're standing on the sidewalk and you get splashed by some car passing through a pothole, how long would you stay dirty? The answer is usually only as long as it takes you to go home and get changed and cleaned up.
Right.
Now, emotionally, we get splashed in life. Mm-hmm. Right. And then we carry that stain sometimes for years.
Sure.
I've had people show me a stain and say, look what happened. I say, when did this happen? When I was 10 years old.
Right.
Right? People carry their emotional stain, their psychological stain, because they don't have a system for their hygiene.
Okay.
Okay? So when I talk about recovery, recovery is about acquiring, learning, and practicing how to live a mental, emotional, psychological, and spiritual hygiene program. But ultimately, it's to help the person fall in love with living. That living is no longer a chore. Mm-hmm. Living is not something that's made difficult and that needs to be, that pain needs to be alleviated by medicating, but rather the person is in love with life, in love with living their life, in love with being well.
Okay.
To me, the real true measure of recovery is when you see the person and you see that this person is a person that loves living. They really appreciate every day they have. Not every day might be a great day. Not every day is a stellar day, but they love the adventure. They love discovering their own adventure of living, you know? That, to me, is recovery.
So abstinence would be the platform from which you jump off into your recovery and start to figure out your finer points of life in an abstinent world.
Yes, absolutely. And well said, because without the abstinence, the recovery cannot happen.
Impossible.
But abstinence alone is not the goal. Absolutely.
Great. Wonderful. Thank you, Richard Hoffman.